summary of what we've learned, rational number is nothing but any number which can be expressed in the form p by q, where q is not equal to 0 and p and q are both integers. The properties that are true for whole numbers and integers, the two properties commutativity and associativity, are also true for rational numbers. Because for these two properties, what we saw is that the group that a number belongs to does not matter, they are always true. The third property, closure, is slightly different based on the group of numbers that you select, right? So for the closure property, addition and multiplication are always closed, be it whole numbers, integers, or rational numbers. Division is never closed, and subtraction is not closed for whole numbers, but it is closed for integers and rational numbers. Then we saw the negative of a number. Negative of a number is nothing but when addition gives zero. That is, you put or remove the minus sign. If there is a minus sign, you remove it. If there isn't, you put one. Reciprocal of a number, nothing but when multiplication gives one. The way to find a reciprocal is just reverse the number and keep the sign as it is. Make the numerator the denominator the numerator. If you have an integer which does not have a denominator, what will the denominator be? It is 1, right? We don't write the denominator because it is 1. So if you have integers, you will take the denominator as 1, and then you can very easily find the reciprocal. Finally, we saw how to represent rational numbers on a number line. We saw how to represent them on a number line. First, represent it as a mixed fraction. The integer portion tells you which two integers the rational number lies between. The denominator tells you how many parts you need to divide the line. So if you have one integer 2 by 9, it tells you the rational number lies between 1 and 2 because you have one integer here. So you will take 1 and 2. Denominator is 9, so you will divide it into 9 parts. Numerator is 2, so you will pick the second part. That will give you your 11 by 9. Finally, finding a rational number between two rational numbers, there will always be an infinite number of rational numbers between any two rational numbers. And if you keep finding progressive midpoints, you will be able to find several of them. Finding rational numbers using numerator integers is another way, but it will not help you find infinite number of numbers. So the midpoint is the easier way to find any number of rational numbers between two rational numbers.